I'm Lev Barshevsky. Thank you for watching our program from the Studio One. So we continue our series, The People of the Politics. And as you know, we're inviting always these very distinguished guests, the elected officials, famous politicians, to share their view on the current issues. And the idea is for our viewers to get known better, our politicians, know what they're working on, and be aware of what's going on in our state, in our district, around us. And today we invited Assemblywoman Helene Weinstein. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Lev, for inviting me.
So good to see you in our studio, and I think that our conversation will touch many important issues our voters are very interested in. Let me remind our viewers that Helene Weinstein was first elected to the Assembly of State of New York in 1980. It means that next year you would celebrate 35 years how you're serving in the interest of our community, in the interest of the people of New York. That's a big life. You did a lot of for that. And Helene Weinstein is known very good in the assembly and in the state as an advocate for children, women, senior citizens. Why this issue is so important for you? Why they attract you?
So part of why I've been in the legislature as long as I have and continue to serve is that I'm a very activist legislator, not just here in Brooklyn in my helping people in the community, but I'm very involved in legislation. As a lawyer, I know how to write legislation, and representing a district that is basically a middle-class community and people who are living, seniors in particular, living on fixed income. I have represented a district that people need the government for assistance, for help. They're not sending their children to fancy, in a lot of my district, not sending their children to fancy private schools. So I need to work for children to make sure there's funding for education. This year we did a very large enactment of legislation for to have pre-K programs
universal pre-K
for well in the elementary schools. That's something that started in the 80s in our community right here in Sheepshead Bay, where myself and other legislators would provide funds to one or two schools to have a pre-K program, because we knew that if the children can start education a little, get a few hours of education a little bit earlier, as they grow up, they're gonna do better in school and be able to accomplish more. So that's something that's...
Yes, that's a favorite child of the New York mayor, Mr. Bill de Blasio.
Well, I did tell the mayor that it started right here in Sheepshead Bay in the 80s. The first pre-K, actually I think it was 1978 was the first time there was a pre-K, right before I was elected in this community. And when I go to graduations, education has always been very important to me. When I go to graduations, particularly high school graduations, I tell the children, now that the young adults, now that I'm getting a little bit older also, I say we're depending on you to work hard because to get a job, because we're going to need you to pay our Social Security, all of us up here. So we need to make sure that they're people. But in Albany, I do a lot of work on legislation to help women who are single mothers raising a family. Women who are victims of domestic violence. As the chair of the Judiciary Committee, mm-hmm. I use our committee to help write the laws to protect the victims of domestic violence. The other issue that's a big senior issue and a women's issue and a children's issue that people sometimes don't recognize as such is what happens when a spouse dies. And when a husband dies and you have an estate, during my tenure as chair of judiciary and in the time I've been in the legislature, we've made changes into the law to make sure that the widow, the children, aren't left destitute, to have enough money to be able to live their lives when their spouse dies. So that's, sometimes people don't think of that as an issue that affects families, but it's very important what happens.
But speaking about such thing as domestic violence and child abuse, so as time goes by, the statistics is getting better on this issue, or it's still...
You know, it's hard to tell with statistics, Lev, because what happens is you don't know if more crimes are being reported, because a lot of... whether it's sexual assault, domestic violence, people used to be afraid to come forward and speak. Now, it's on the news, and you hear about with the incidents with football players. Mm-hmm. So more people are becoming, over the years, more people are becoming aware. And one of the big problems when, so we're trying to do things to, what we've done over the years and continue to do is protect the victim, put laws in place to protect the victim, put laws in place to punish the abuser, and to make it safe for someone to leave the abuser. For so many women who are victims of domestic violence, they can't leave because economically they're dependent on the person who's abusing them for their survival. So we've made changes in the law so that the women would be able financially to be able to leave the abusive situation. But more needs to be done. I'd like there to be a year I return to Albany and we don't have to introduce a new bill on domestic violence or a new bill on sexual assault because we've solved the problem. But it's you know, clearly a problem goes across lots of communities, lots of different states, but I'd like to think that some of the laws that I've worked on are making a difference and making it safer for people in our community.
When I tried to make myself familiar with legislation that you either sponsored or co-sponsored, I found some very interesting thing, like safety belts in the school buses, mm-hmm. or the prohibition of the junk food before the mm-hmm. end of the lunch. So now it works in the schools.
It does, and with the junk, you know, now people are much more conscious about what they eat and what they feed the children. It's still, every year you have to still, there's still new information and trying to teach people more about good eating. When we, the stopping junk food in schools before lunch, we passed that legislation 20 years ago, more than 20 years ago. And there was such lobbying from the candy makers. I was having people come from, like Hershey's was coming in to the session. They were sending over chocolate bars to tell me how good it was for people to eat them. So all my colleagues would come over to come get some of the candy that they were bringing in on a late night. But it was an important bill to do at the time to help promote healthy eating amongst children. The requirement of seat belts on school buses, we did that before there was the requirement in the state that people in the front seat have to wear seat belts, because we recognized, and I was able to convince my colleagues that we had to make a safer environment for children, both in school and when they are going home from school.
Thank you very much for working on such issues. Very important for our kids and grandkids. And just one more question. again about the universal pre-K. Is the system work now? Is this program work?
We have so greatly expanded with hundreds of millions of dollars pre-K here in the city. It is definitely working. It is so important for children to be able to do that. I know when I was a little girl, my mother sent me to nursery school because there was no pre-K. But it is very, very important for the children, and it's also important for parents. There's many families, both parents need to, if there's two parents, they both need to work, or there's a single parent. You know, so a lot of grandparents take care of children, but a lot of times the children need to be in school, so it also saves money, the family, to not have to find private daycare or private school for the children who are very young. But it makes a difference, and children are getting a much better education.
I wish you every success in continuing to work on this issue, because such a vulnerable categories of the citizens, like women, children, senior citizens, they want our care as a society, as a community, and on behalf of all our viewers, thank you very much for working on that. So let me remind you that our guest today is Assemblywoman Helene Weinstein. Thank you for coming.
So happy to be here.
Thank you. And stay with us. We will continue this series.